Dr. Akkerman. I was lucky enough to recently coordinate an event with jazz vocalist Kevin Mahogany, and in between playing songs, he took questions from the audience and discussed topics about performance and the business of music. I think what's interesting about what he was saying is how many different paths his career has taken over the years. He's sung lots of different styles of music. He's had record deals with independent companies, major record companies, and now he runs his own record company. He's even taught at colleges along the way. I think there's something we could all learn from that kind of diversity. There's lots of different ways to make money as a musician. Let's join Kevin as he talks about his career path.
So in college is when I started focusing more on singing. I started my own vocal jazz choir where I was at the university, because they didn't have one at that time. I was also gigging on the weekends back in Kansas City. And I was playing in the pit orchestras at the university. At that time, I was playing clarinet and saxophone and flute, which is the natural doubles for my horn and bass clarinet. So I was getting pretty well-rounded education there. I was going to graduate school. Actually, I take it back. I went to graduate school, but I escaped. They're still looking for me, actually. I got out of there, I got back home to Kansas City, and started singing around town in R&B bands. The first group was a nine-piece horn band, where I was singing a lot of old Motown, 60s Motown and R&B, you know, Otis Redding, Wilson Pickett, James Brown, Sam Cooke, because I see the blank face, the blank looks at it, ooh! Yeah, well, yeah, I'm a little older than I would. But did a lot of 60s Motown. Well, let's put it this way, the Temptations, the Four Tops, all that kind of stuff we were doing. And I started putting together my own ensembles. I ended up getting my first record deal back in the 90s, actually late 80s. I got my first record deal. I signed to a record label from Germany called Inja. I released three projects from there. I left Inja and went to Warner Brothers. Released four projects on Warner Brothers. I left there, did a little recording project for a label called Telarc, and now I have my own record label, Mahogany Jazz. We've been releasing material lately. Actually, this year we just signed two other acts to the label. So that's what I'm doing in a nutshell, which brings me to here. In between time, I also happen to do a little teaching. I taught for a few years at Berklee College of Music in Boston. I also taught at the University of Miami, Florida, where I live now. So that's my life in a nutshell. I'm trying to cut out the boring parts. Because I didn't tell you that I actually, when I went to college, I was originally studying chemical engineering. But I found out they frown on it when you flunk your major. So I didn't do too well in chemistry. So I said, well, maybe this is not my career path. So I chose another direction, which is the music that I've always been involved in. And so I've been doing this, let me see. This year is my 38th year as a professional musician. Now a lot of people look at that and say, oh man, most people have retired after spending 38 years in one job. For some of us, the job is really just starting. That's the thing about music. It is not a career that you can put a time span on. Most of the musicians that I truly respect and admire passed away performing this music. Just this past week, a good friend of mine passed away, Fathead Newman. If you don't know who he is, he's a great tenor player, considered one of the best Texas tenors. He used to play with Ray Charles' orchestra. He used to play with Billy Eckstein's orchestra. And if you don't know those names, all I can tell you is, get on the internet. Yeah. So that's how I've been surviving lately, singing and performing jazz and working with wonderful musicians.